Thank you for joining this presentation. My name is Martijn Starmans. I'm a PhD student at the Erasmus Medical Center in the Netherlands. Today I will discuss a bit about my work on using a radiomics model to predict the development of HCC on liver MRI in high-risk patients in surveillance. I have no conflicts of interest to disclose. So in this session, we're of course concerned with HCC, and we see that many guidelines recommend surveillance for HCC with ultrasound twice per year for patients at risk. So we know that ultrasound has a limited sensitivity, and we saw in one of the earlier talks in this session that we may also use MRI instead of ultrasound for detection these tumors. However, besides detecting these tumors, it would be even more beneficial if at an earlier stage, we may already be able to predict whether a patient will develop HCC later on. So therefore, the goal of this study is to do that using radiomics based on MRI of the normal liver parenchyma. Let's first take a look at the dataset that we used. As a proof of concept, we first looked at two extrema. On one hand, we have livers in which no HCC developed during the whole surveillance period. On the other hand, we have livers at the point of first detection of HCC, so the HCC is already present at this time point. We ended up with 154 patients, which were referred to a hospital for surveillance of HCC, which were deemed unsuitable for ultrasound. So all of these patients have at least a T2-weighted and a diffusion-weighted MRI. We have two B-values for the diffusion-weighted imaging, a high and a low one, but since the low B-value diffusion-weighted image is pretty similar to the T2, we will only use the high B-value image. So of all these patients, about half is HCC naive, so these didn't develop an HCC, and about half developed an HCC. Next, let's take a look at the radiomics method. So we start off with the T2-weighted MRIs. On these images, a clinician manually segmented the normal liver parenchyma. So this means for patients in which an HCC was present, the HCC was not included in the segmentation, only the normal liver parenchyma. When using the diffusion-weighted imaging, these were not manually segmented, but we use image registration to warp the segmentation from the T2 automatically to the diffusion-weighted imaging. Next, for all these images, we extract some features. So these features give us information about the liver parenchyma. We use simple descriptors such as intensity, for example, the mean intensity of the tumor. We did not use any shape descriptors because if HCC was present, this was cut out of the liver in the segmentation, so this might alter the shape, so we're not looking at shape to not be biased. We also use more complex features, texture features, such as the heterogeneity of these livers. So we end up for each patient with features, and we also know the labels of these patients, so whether they developed an HCC or not. Next, we're going to use machine learning and some pre-processing methods to develop a decision model. Beforehand, we do not, however, know which machine learning method is most suitable. So instead of just picking one method, we've collected a wide variety of pre-processing and machine learning methods, and we use automatic algorithm optimization to automatically determine which combination of parameters and methods gives us the optimal decision model. Let's take a look at some of the results. So on the left, I've included a table with some clinical characteristics of the patients. May you be interested. In the radiomics experiments, I've used a 100 times random split cross-variation to make sure we train and test on different parts of the dataset. And on the right, you can see some of those results. So on the top right, you see the ROC curve of the model when using the T2 and the DWI weighted imaging. And you can see that the model performs quite a bit better than simply guessing. From the table, you can see what happens when we only use T2 or DWI, and you can see that the performance drops a little bit. So what can we conclude from these results? Well, we see from the results that there's a difference in appearance in livers in which HCC has developed from livers in which no HCC will develop, and that radiomics can actually be used to distinguish these two patients. So such a model may be used in screening to distinguish between patients which are at risk for developing HCC and which are not, but also maybe to find patients suitable for screening. So our study has some limitations. First of all, we currently looked as a proof of concept at two extrema, livers in which no HCC will develop versus livers in which HCC has already developed. But our ultimate aim is to do a longitudinal study where we can actually predict whether an HCC will develop in the future instead of looking at livers at the time point in which HCC has already developed. Second, we currently rely on manual annotations, which is not feasible in clinical practice since it's time consuming. So this might, for example, be solved by using automated methods using deep learning. Here is my ethics and funding information. Last but not least, the Radioinks method we used is open source, so you can use it as well. It's pretty easy to use because it automatically determines the best combination of methods out of its huge collections of methods which is included. And it's a pretty generic solution. So if you look at this year's ECR, but also previous year's ECR, we've demonstrated that this work toolbox works very well in a wide variety of clinical applications. So if you want to try it out, here's a link to the software, or feel free to email me. Thanks for joining this presentation. If you have any questions or want to collaborate on this topic, feel free to send me an email.